Okay, 200 bucks for 10 minutes. Anything you want, you just gotta make it quick, all right?
I don't have the cash right now.
Then come back when you do, sweetheart.
Hey!
Oh! I wasn't ready. I'm not ready. I want to get my gun out, man. Wrong gun. Nope. Okay. Yeah, if I could just get that out quicker, that'd be great. That wasn't supposed to happen. No. I can't even put it away. I guess I gotta that's messed up. Let's load this one. Alright, I'll see you guys in a little while. Okay. I have to completely restart. Alright, so what do I still have to do? Hack this? I don't know why that was happening. I have to lead her away, don't I? Not kill any innocents if possible. So I have that much money. I guess I can spare 200.
Yeah. What are you looking for, honey? Okay, 200 bucks for 10 minutes. Anything you want, you just gotta make it quick, all right?
Fine, here's the money.
All right. Just meet me in the Pleasure Palace, the room at the back of the hall. Your time just started.
All right, all right. Go back and get ready. I'll be there in a second. Now she left, right? She's not left. No loss of innocent life. Can I do some dancing? Oops. You've eliminated the hunter Chastity. The Velvet Velour at the Vesuvius, you'll want to know. Now I can also get my,
Hey, I was waiting in there for 10 minutes. What's your problem?
That was not 10 minutes. Go back in there. I'll be there in a second. You mean stay in here?
It's gonna cost you another 200.
I don't have that kind of green. I'm out of here. Yeah, I'm curious, actually. Oh, I can't now. I can't talk to her. Never mind. Well, that was cool. Oh. Dirty dog. See ya. What a wonderful place. Vesuvius. Velvet Velour. And then we gotta find a telephone. To reach these snuff film people. That wasn't too tough, huh? Weapons not allowed. Oh, I just want to reload it.
Look who's back.
She jiggled. Miss Velour.
Yes.
About that hunter.
Mm-hmm.
The hunter's dead.
I know. I heard you from here. So you like loud noises, do you? I asked you to be quiet. All you've done is attract attention to yourself. And now you're in my club. You think there's any chance someone might make the connection? I don't know if you've helped or made things worse.
Well, I use guns, you know? Yeah, I'm sorry about that. Things got out of hand.
Fine. Apology accepted. Only because no one else got hurt.
Well, I could fly off the handle, or I could ask her a question.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about Isaac.
I adore Isaac. He's the father I never had. Why, if anything happened to him, I'd just end it all. But nothing ever will. Isaac's gifted, a saintly patron of the arts, and the most respected kindred in this city.
Well, you know, nothing would ever happen to him.
Mm-hmm.
You know anything about a snuff film?
No. Are you into that kind of thing? Ugh.
No.
Mm-hmm.
See if she says anything different.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, forget it. I've gotta go.
Poor David what? Hatter.
What? Who?
David Hatter's an aspiring screenwriter and hotel manager. He comes in more often than he would admit. Several years now. Poor dear just can't get a break. I overheard him talking about his new screenplay with one of my girls. It was about secret societies and creatures that found themselves dealing with inner beasts and persecution by elder monsters. Sound reminiscent of something to you?
Yeah, our whole existence. The Bush administration. Share bears. The game industry. So I see what she'll say. He's writing a movie about the Bush administration?
No. It's about kindred The details of his story were too insightful to be coincidental. I think someone's working with David. A kindred who doesn't realize the consequences of their actions. Do you know what the penalty for revealing ourselves to Kine is?
No Christmas bonus?
Death. I'm afraid poor David's big break. The screenplay he's worked so hard on must be destroyed, and his less than silent partner must be executed. I know David too well. I'm very fond of David, and I'm too close to do what needs to be done.
So the screenplay must be destroyed and his partner must be executed. You're asking me to destroy Hatter's screenplay?
I don't think Hatter knows his collaborator is kindred. You'll have to take David's screenplay, and somehow you'll have to coax the name of his source out of him. Once you've found out who, kill the traitor. But do not touch David.
Wait, so you want me to kill again? No.
It's not my law. Telling humans about the Masquerade is against the laws of every faction of kindred society. There are many that are aware of us as it is. If more become suspicious, it could mean our extinction.
Good point. Yeah, okay, I'll find the kindred traitor and kill them.
David works at the Lucky Star Motel. He's very passionate about his writing. He loves to talk about his craft. I'm sure he'll talk about his screenplay. It may take some persuasion to get him to give up his collaborator's name, however.
Persuasion? Leave it to me.
After this is over, I promise. You'll have my complete attention.
Does some more questions? Well, she's All right. Are we really done this time? Give me the cash. David Hatter is a writer who works as a night clerk at the Lucky Star Motel. He has written a screenplay about kindred society with an unknown collaborator. The manuscript and the collaborator must be destroyed, but Velvet Velour wants you to spare Hatter. Alright, let's go. I'm gonna go to Lucky Star Motel soon, because we also have to go there for Durbin. Clues to Durbin, and or what happened to Milton. So Gary, I guess once we find this tape for Isaac, he'll help us with Gary. My phone behind the red spot. And I have to say something? I don't remember what it was that they said, hopefully. Hello?
The moon is a mysterious mistress.
Who walks the night with demons of dread?
The Lucky Star Motel, room 2. Don't be long.
Alright, look like everything's converging on the Lucky Star Motel. I'll be there. Is this the way? What's the other place that, Lucky Star is, I guess, behind me. Red spot. Is that Vesuvius that sells that stuff too? Sinbin? Sinbin is where I was before, right? There's a Lucky Star. So it wasn't behind me, it was in front of me. Bear with me, guys, just... Yeah, Sinbin. Yeah, let's go to Lucky Star. Or let's... Yeah, Lucky Star. Because there is plenty. We have three things to do here. Well, this is Lucky Star. Fire. I cannot feel it through my undead wounds.
Sorry, no vacancies.
No, I'm just taking a look around.
Feel free, babe. This is a treasure trove of human banality. Working here, you meet lots of types of men. You get stories, you get characters, you know. This is kind of place where writers go to study human behavior, man. It's invaluable.
I'll play dumb, of course. You're a writer?
Writer's such a tarnished term, you know what I mean? It's like every other guy says he's a writer, right? Like, you write a letter, you're a writer, you know? It's like, what I do, that's screenwriting. Like, I encapsulate the essence of excellent film in my scripts, all right? Like, I'm like a blacksmith with pens, all right? I'm a welder of montage.
Master Spaz, what do you write?
Does a writer write, or does he just, like, ink the flotsam and jetsam floating in his subconscious into a 120-page piece of film genius? But
I'm sure you're telling
me. Most of my subconscious is filled with old horror films, so that's what I write mostly, I guess.
Have you seen that snuff film with the monsters? Talk about horror.
Trash. That ain't horror. Horror is scary, like hairs on the back of your neck, you know what I'm saying? Like afraid to go in a dark room. That tape, that's for sick people, like disturbed types, you know?
Yeah, I don't want to freak him out too much. What are you writing now?
Me? I'm like looking to redefine the vampire movie, okay? Like, tons of people make vampire flicks, okay, popular characters, but me, I'm gonna be doing the real deal. Like, not only is it gonna be scary, but it's gonna be, like, it's gonna be believable.
Vampires? What do you know about vampires?
Well, in my story, it's not like about garlic and bats, okay? It's about vampire societies and stuff. You know, like, what would vampires be really all about? I mean, how do they blend into society without being discovered?
You know, I could get a Masquerade redemption if I'm doing this right. Could you imagine? I'm sorry, you must die. Yeah, that's not what you want done. I'd love to see that. Do you have a copy around here?
A good writer always does in this town. Hey, you in the business? Because, man, I got tons of ideas for movies. In fact, I should give you one of my completed screenplays. This one's still a work in progress.
I know a few people interested in making a vampire pick.
You do? Man, that's fantastic! I can give you my screenplay if you promise to keep it safe.
You do? Man, that's fantastic. I'm reading his line. Duh. Don't worry about it. Say, any co-writers or collaborators?
I really can't talk about it. He likes his privacy.
Here's my offer. You get to keep your eyes if you tell me.
His name? He goes by Julius. That's all I know. I'm supposed to meet him tonight. He's just a weird beach bum under the Santa Monica Pier. Man, why are you doing this to me?
Huh. Thank you for your cooperation, David. Remember, about all this... Shh. You've been successful in your quest to obtain David Hatter's collaborator's name. It's Julius, one of the thin bloods that hangs out on the beach in Santa Monica. And the anonymous caller has told you to go to the Hollywood Lucky Star Motel Room 2. So let's take a look at the screenplay. An envelope with David Hatter's screenplay. It is tentatively titled Humanity versus the Vampire Lords. Really? Oof! I got 20 experience. Let me take this thaumaturgy blood theft. The blood of the target will be drained and sent to you, then the victim dies. Sounds good. I got blood theft.
Area code 323-KL5-KTRK.
What you got back there? David, a guest has left a laptop in room 3. The password is Lycans, but it only has a weird poem on it. See if you can determine the guest's home address. Christoph.
Voluntarily eat insects in some countries.
Yeah, well, those countries probably need Jesus.
So, you never sleep at night. I assume you do sleep, right?
I sleep at work.
And what exactly do you do?
I'm a middle school teacher.
That would explain why my nephew invested.
Oh, that's Al? Duh. I thought I was going in a separate area inside. Okay. This is... Oh, okay. Huh. Room 2.
Oh my god! My work is done.
What the hell? Using the key you found at the last murder site, you burst into a room at the Lucky Star Motel just in time to see the serial killer make his escape. That's Durbin? Like an experience just for watching that. Oh, okay. Brothers Salvage. Quest log updated. You need a melee ability of at least 2. Brothers Salvage, Santa Monica. Oh yeah, yeah, I know where that is. It's been blocked off. I guess now we can get to it. Where's this body? So he broke the window with the door. Okay. Oh, 6. I see the numbers. Can't get into 5. Can I boost this? Lock picking is 6. Yeah, it's not. I need another point. And lock picking. Points necessary to do that. Room 4. Again. Wait. Gold ring. Internet cafe key. Is this where it happened? Skill of 8. Wow. Let's show up under keys. Internet cafe key. Oh, that's to get further back into that area. Yeah, I'll gladly go back there. Is this 2? This is 1. This was supposed to go into two, right? There was no one waiting for you at the Hollywood Lucky Star Motel, but you did find a key to the internet cafe. No, we can't get into. Alright, so maybe that was the one we wanted. That is two. This is what, eight, yeah. I've been over here. So there's two that I need to undo. Well, not undo, but unlock. With a skill of eight. Do I have the... I got some more points, didn't I? I need two more. I'm gonna have to fight those things, aren't I? You found a business card from Brother Salvage in Santa Monica at the latest murder scene. What if that was Durbin? Well, I guess I'll go back to the internet cafe since we're here. It's not this way, is it? Here it is. So this is to get the tape. Now we got this going on. Oh!